There's people that are watching this, like, where y'all are arguing about happiness or not.
Yes.
I would love to be. Y'all got the computer, the camera, the subscribers, the views. You guys are living LA as friends together.
I haven't seen this. It's called happiness. So I would like to be more happy.
That'd be nice.
33.5 million views.
I haven't ever seen this. Life is but a rat.
Rat race.
Ah. Damn, it's a rat race. Okay.
See, I see why you got, see, mm-hmm. It makes sense. Everything's connecting.
They have this ties on, a suit and tie.
Oh, wow. It's New York.
Commuting. Everyone's identical. Nowhere.
Nowhere is the location.
Advertisements. Look at that.
Miscellaneous meat.
This is really how it be though.
This is what real life is like.
Trump, the musical.
Happiness showing tonight.
So what out.
Look at that. All the advertisements. Wow.
Companies.
Is this not exactly what life is?
Yep.
Go to point A, to point B, to point C.
Consumerism.
And yet we all still go and
we keep buying.
Participate.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's Black Friday.
This is facts. And people do this shit for this.
Mm-hmm. People get trampled every year with this.
Ah.
New flashy car.
Materialistic.
It's saying, no, this is happiness.
Having the nice car.
Oh.
Temporary happiness.
Oh.
Life's not fair.
Happiness, it must be there.
Drink your life away.
Happy to
the drink. I mean, that's every product. You need us.
That's so many people in their 20s drinking.
Blackout.
To be happy. It's fun. Oh my goodness.
No, not the pills.
Shit. This ain't fun.
Don't dive in.
Bruh.
Ooh.
Yeah, he's hallucinating.
He on some psychedelics.
He's happy.
Everything is just magical.
He's found it. The answer was the pills.
Oh shit. Back to reality.
Who edited this?
Not the prostitute rat with six nipples. Chasing the money.
Chasing after the money.
You could have picked it up in the elevator.
There it is. Rat trap.
Oh, you're right.
Wow.
I swear to God, I've not watched this.
They kind of jam-packed everything into that one video, which was pretty interesting.
I didn't see one lie in there.
Dang, and then happiness just turns off.
Everyone wants to be more happy. The main thing that people seek out. Contentness, or if not that, then happiness. And we're told, if you get this, then you'll be happy.
So is the key to always look for happiness and to know that happiness is not everlasting?
And there's so many tropes about happiness. Like, happiness isn't a destination. It's like a mindset. Why do you see little poor African children in African villages dancing and laughing and smiling when theoretically they have next to nothing? People will be spoiled in the US and be depressed. I would say it's fair to say that happiness is internal and comes from within.
I heard something like your perceived reality is your reality. So whatever you think in your head is what it is. That's what you're gonna think it is.
If you're perceiving something bad, negative, oh, this sucks.
Wait, nobody likes you, duh. That's what what you're gonna get. Yeah.
Most humans get put on that conveyor belt. You're in the rat race to
it's a cycle. Yeah.
Get your job. Commute to work. Oh, the happiness isn't it. If you get the car, then you'll be happy. If you get this, then you'll be happy. Oh, the drugs. Oh, the doctor prescribed happy pills. Blah blah blah.
Which in theory makes you happy, but I guess in that moment, or even what is happy though.
Yeah, they didn't say true happiness. This is just happiness.
You get fleeting happiness.
Yeah, fleeting happiness from each one of those things that they showed us.
It's smacked back down into reality.
Yeah, and then you go right back.
And it's like, well, I gotta get this money. You chase the money, and then boom, you're trapped. You need money to make shit happen.
Happiness can't be found through money then? Can you be happy through everything else?
People say money doesn't buy happiness. Money buys freedom. Freedom is happiness. Well, I think I read it in a book. It was like, people who say that money doesn't buy happiness ain't got enough of it. If you can be free and have your family be free, I think it's easier to find happiness.
Yeah, because your mind and perception of happiness would change depending on what situation you're in. Like you said, you could be in Africa and still be happy, or you can, I don't know, be recording a video and be happy. Would you say you're happy right now?
Truthfully, no.
Right? Like, I wouldn't say I'm exuding happiness right now, but I'm not mad.
I think we also have the self-awareness to know that we're in a safe environment, things aren't too bad, everything will pretty much work out, so we're not sad, but are we truly exuding happiness? I don't think I am.
No.
Is that because we just know what else is out there and we know the levels of where we could go?
Does it?
So we're like unhappy with not being at certain levels
that we think mean
happiness?
Exactly.
But let's say we all have our own humongous mansion house.
And now you're touching on a thing that I constantly think about, which is, damn, once I get this big house, then I'll be like, ah. Yet, I remember thinking, if I could get 1 million subscribers, if I could get 100K subscribers, bro, I'll be so happy.
But then I can also remember, being in college when we had that in a little dinky dorm room, I was pretty happy a lot of the time, like got something cool going on.
So I think happiness is just perceived then.
We're so used to getting newer things along the way, whether it's success or material stuff, where it's like, we get a little bit more of each of these things. That's our happiness. But some people are on a different route where just getting that free weekend to go to that one vacation.
I heard this quote too. Money won't buy happiness, but it's a damn good down payment.
Mm-hmm. That's fine.
In my eyes, okay, money doesn't buy happiness. Well, you know what? I want to find out. So I want to try to get a lot of money.
It doesn't buy happiness, but it'll make you happier. And you give anybody $100, I'm happier. And so you spend it.
Then you go, oh, fuck. I want something that you think will make you happier.
Yeah. But then if you have a whole bunch of don't spend it, what? You know, buy $500, but you say here's $500, but you can't spend it.
Then isn't it useless?
Well, I don't want it.
Well, can one thing or one material thing make you happy forever? I don't think so, right? So life. I think we only look for happiness in periods.
Life is almost like a Mario Kart game. Buying things is like when you get the little power ups and get the little shit, zing, and then you're floating on it.
It'll help you for that level, but there's always gonna be another level where you have to then get more things and find more happiness.
I am a complete slave to consumerism. Why am I wearing this essentials thing?
Well, it looked dope.
It looked dope.
It feel dope.
I feel cool.
Good quality.
But am I happy?
But that's weird because what made me happy as a kid. What made me happy as a kid don't make me happy now.
Exactly. So
like I just needed an ice pop and some Doritos and two people to hang out with outside. Good to go. The whole year. Every year we're a different person, so we need new things to make us happy for this year.
Great point about happiness as a kid. I would pack a lunch and then my mom would put something in like donut holes or something, my favorite thing. Put them in there, and when it came lunchtime, oh my god, I was so happy.
My excitement was the unknown of when I'd go to the lunch line and I'd see what's on the menu today, and I'm like, oh, we have this today.
Pizza parties.
Or at the end of the year, we all get to get the foam, clean our desk.
Foam to clean the desk.
Fun day, we get to go outside with the moon bounces.
The field day, the motherfucking getting a little mint. Like when we were taking MSA.
Little assessment test.
Did you have that? Maryland State Assessment, MSA.
You had a different version, some sort of.
Or like CSA,
something like that.
Yeah.
I felt like I was far happier as a kid than I am now. And I can order pizza every time, every day. I can get as many mints as I want.
Yeah, I couldn't get Domino's every day as a kid. It'd be like, maybe on Friday, every other weekend. Maybe.
It was like the less that you had it, it meant more when you got it.
So then, like we said, if we have millions of dollars, everybody's happy, content, you can pay for everything. You can get anything.
Yeah, but then you see the richest people in the world have all the money, but are not happy.
There are suicidal celebrities, rich people.
You ever heard Logan Paul on his podcast was saying how like all the billionaires he's talked to, he's like, yeah, most of them I talked to is like, they're not all that happy. Not every one of them.
And you hear it all the time, do what makes you happy. How does somebody find that?
But then it sucks because stuff that we did as a kid that made us happy, like making these videos, well, now it's a job. But you have to still find that happiness of why you did it before.
Yeah, but that's different because when you're younger, you don't really understand what life is. Like, you can't eat pizza every day because you're going to have high cholesterol and you're going to be able to...
Organs are fresh, so you can eat that type of stuff.
You can eat that type of stuff.
You're also not seeking happiness as a kid. It's handed to you in a way.
But then again, even like my parents weren't giving me food every day, like McDonald's and stuff. I can still go outside and play with two sticks and like found some type of happiness with my own imagination.
We were content and happy playing out in the yard in the grass making mud pies. Mm-hmm. And now we have all the entertainment, all the food, all this.
So do you think this is making us more unhappy because we have too much to look at?
Yeah, because the more opportunities, the more different avenues and things you can do, it makes you think and it makes you like affect the way you actually are.
And this just makes sense or not, but like how we get mad looking at our old photos, like I wish we would have dressed like that or had that haircut. But because we didn't have anything to kind of go off of, like with the phone and everybody having to get the right likes on Instagram.
So the camera died. And this is what it looks like when we film our videos. We exhausted the battery because we've been reacting all day.
We have so much of a dopamine overload, all these stimulants. Things start to lose their sparkle when you get them all the time. If you keep getting stimulated, your bar for happiness, pleasure keeps going up. If your favorite thing is pizza and you have pizza every day, it don't taste as good as when you never get it. So if you go on a diet and you don't have any candy, and then you eat candy, that bitch is sweet as fuck.
Yeah, I noticed when I bought so much clothes, I almost just wanted to not do it for a long time. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, why am I just doing it? And then when you do get something here and there, you're like, oh, feel special when you get your little new piece.
Yeah, everyone knows that feeling for sure.
I've watched a documentary called Minimalism 4 times. And every time I watch it, I'm like, throw everything out. Get rid of your shit, whatever. If you think you're going to buy something and it's going to make you happier, it makes you happy for a second. And then until it doesn't.
Yeah. How do you know what you think is going to make you happy and what you know is going to make you happy, or do you not?
It sounds nice, right? Like, don't want things and don't spend money and just be happy with yourself. That's easier said than done. And I would rather be sad in a Lambo than sad in a Toyota Camry. Like, oh man.
Aww.
Lamb truck. Skirt. How do you become happy?
I do think the mindset thing, it has to go back to that. Yeah. There's people that are watching this, like, where y'all are arguing about happiness or not.
Yes.
I would love to be, y'all got the computer, the camera, the subscribers, the views. You guys are living LA as friends together. And it's like, oh shit, well, I think of it that way, I'm like, oh, you're right.
But I think that also brings us happiness, thinking about that. Like, we can sit back and be like, you know what, we're blessed about anything. Anyone can sit back and think about that. So you don't constantly have that feeling.
No, you have to take a step back here and there when you're upset and think about all the good things in your life. That's why they always say, if you're really down, well, write down all the positive things.
Yeah, take a step back, take a deep breath.
Because like you said, we probably manufacture more problems than we actually have.
Correct.
Especially if we look at people that have disabilities and conditions and diseases where you're like, oh shit, it's not as bad, but there's still, our problems still hold weight just in a different way. Well, I heard somebody say it was like, every time you have a problem, just search for a solution.
To your point, yes, people would look at us and go, if only I were them.
They're doing it right now.
Yet, here we are
complaining,
admitting that we are not supremely happy. So what does that say? You look at people, Juice WRLD. That dude was taking so much lean to numb his feelings.
I mean, because he said in his interview that nothing felt real. When they try to explain, like, you know what type of figure you are?
You are a generational. You're so superstar.
You've done all this. But yet he still felt empty inside. His song felt empty, but it's just. I think the good thing is that there's a similarity with everybody.
Yeah.
We're all looking at people where we're like, that we look up to that have this or that. Like, oh, they must be having it.
And we all have certain things in our mind that we think will make us happy. So that's why we constantly look be happier. And what else can we get?
And I put on my vision board when we were in college, 5 million subscribers. And then now we're at almost 8.
And why am I so sad that we're not at 10?
In this never ending pursuit for more.
Yeah, and I'm sure once we hit 10, we're going at 20.
You always feel like you need to get something bigger and better and something new. How does that affect somebody?
Isn't that the human condition to constantly seek out challenges, problems, the next thing? If supreme happiness is content, like, I don't need any more subscribers, then it's like, okay, then I'm done with that. And then what, you become a monk and then...
No, because you would set a new foundation for what's the next thing you want to take over and start with.
I think what is the most fulfilling thing is the journey and not the destination.
That's easier to say and it's hard to appreciate, I think, sometimes when you're in the journey. Because like I said, now that we can look back from our college years, I'm like, damn, that really set us up. Or before you hit 2 million subscribers, you're like, everything leading up to that, pretty amazing.
And then when you hit a certain milestone, it's not as sweet as you thought it was gonna be, or like it's dope and then it goes away very quickly.
Yeah.
And do you think that happens within everybody, or do you think that we're set up in a way where we are wanting to? Some people are okay with that.
They can get to that point, could be early and be like, yeah, I figured it out and this is where I'll coast. But there's also people that probably do think like us, so we're just like, is it wrong that I want this to also also feel happier.
Yeah, is it bad that we're not showing appreciation to where we're at now and always looking for something else?
I've also seen actors and artists that are like really big and they're just like, this is just a start. Like everything that I did in the past was good, but this is just a start now and I figured it out. And I'm like, I look at them like, holy shit, I wish I had an ounce of that. You don't hit the happiness destination. Da da da. Everything's happy now.
I think it's safe to say that everyone will always be seeking something new, a new challenge, a new goal, a new thing, a new target. Otherwise, people will be monks.
You could find happiness every day, and I think you do. Even if the most sad or depressed person will find happiness no matter what. So maybe trying to find, you know, happiness in anything you do. You wake up and you like to listen to music. That makes you somewhat happy. Like, I think finding things like that that make you a little bit happier and doing more of it will overall help you be happy.
Yeah, a happy day strung together would essentially be a happy life.
And not all moments within your day are going to be happy.
But if you can choose to frame your thoughts in such a way that it's positive and happier, then you'd have a happier life.
It's weird, because like even on a day where you're super busy and you go on your phone for 20 minutes, you made you happy because you've got whatever you need out of that, whether it was forgetting your current task or that. But then when you go back to what you're doing, you're like, did I just waste all that time? But you did use that time and it did make you happy.
But then also the trope of do what you love. That's true happiness. Fuck college, dude. Make an entrepreneur, do your own thing. Sometimes you have to do things you don't want to do in order to be happy. So you might have to shovel some dirt to make 10 bucks and then use the 10 bucks to buy your mom a popsicle. And then, oh, that made me really happy. Your whole life can't be seeking out a bunch of happiness. Like, wouldn't you have to, seek discomfort in order to be happy sometimes?
People that are like, I don't know, sad or depressed and they're in their room or whatever, they always say, get out and do something, you know, because that's going to trigger you to do.
Like, everybody's definition of happiness is different. Because we can sit here and go in circles like, yeah, you can look at it, discomfort could equal happy, pleasure happy, materialistic consumerism makes you happy, seeing what somebody else makes them happy, might think that'll make you happy. Right. It's almost funny how this whole thing about happiness was literally shown just like this, like, I don't know, it's funny, like, wasn't that happy watching it? Like, the reality of it.
Right?
Each of those things in that reality caused them happiness.
I know there's gonna be some good ass comments in here. Every man is happy until happiness is suddenly a goal.
Like, next week, I'm going to be happy. You start with just shifting your mind.
So now all up until next week, you're going to make yourself unhappy, which will not sound good.
Absolutely amazing. That's what human life is really, really like. We have misunderstood happiness in a lot of ways. 338 is a scene. I feel like it's a metaphor of people who are trying really hard to get close to happiness. When they're finally close to it, they don't care about it anymore. The money represents happiness. The rat wants to catch it, but when he's next to it in the elevator, it's not reaching. And after the money goes away, he runs after it again.
Yeah, he had the whole time in the elevator to pick it up.
Yeah, that's why I saw that too. I was like, what are we doing?
You gotta grab it.
That's the thing. When he had it, he did not want to pursue anything anymore. So then he was like, I had to watch this for a class where we did, in fact, learn about happiness and the concept as a whole. However, while most of the people are talking about how happiness shouldn't be chased, I think it shows a different message. Consumerism, activities, objects, etc. can bring what I call short-term happiness. But this isn't what we think of when we think of happiness. We're thinking of long-term happiness. Bouncing from thing to thing, hoping to get long-term happiness out of things designed for short-term is not going to work. We get tired, worn out, and get left out of options. Focus on long-term.
But what's long-term happiness? Doing something like what? Like if you always wanted to have a kid, you have a kid and you know that's going to be long-term happiness?
Like if you wanted to buy your mom a house. If you want giving back to your parents, it's something that I think a lot of people would agree with. If that's going to feel better than eating a slice of pizza, then buying a car. Giving sometimes feels better than receiving when you're giving to the person you want to give to the most.
And is that long-term happiness? Because you get reminded of your parents' house like throughout your life? Or can you still like only be happy in that short term? Here's the money and then
it's there for a period of time. It's longer lasting than a candy person.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
How many of these longer term happy moments can you create for yourself?
Yeah.
And even then, ain't that a hustle?
Like, yeah, because like you said, you have to make sacrifices to sometimes get to that point of happiness you want to be or that you're thinking about.
If you look for short-term happiness, short-term junk food, consumerism, spend all your money, that will lead you to the saddest life ever, as we've seen. But seeking the discomfort, if you seek going to the gym all the time, if you seek working really hard and doing things sometimes you don't want to do to get more money so that you can buy a household or buy investment properties or whatever, that will lead you to an easier life per se, leading to more happiness. You probably won't be happy the whole time you're doing it.
But it's so hard to achieve that.
Your end goal is the happiest, very happy.
Yeah.
But then when you get to the end goal,
that's part of it. The only way to collect those long long-term happiness things is to put yourself through stuff like that, maybe.
How is it possible that we all watch this, we all agree, we all shake our heads, yeah, we'll get up tomorrow morning and do it all over again.
You're right.
I guess you have to accept it if you're in that reality. Yeah. You have to accept the reality.
Also still keep moving, still keep going.
Well, life goes on. We can sit here and be like, oh, what's the point?
Yeah, why
I'm gonna be more sad if I don't keep moving tomorrow. I have to. That's how it is.
At least if you can get woken up a little bit.
Yeah.
So many people are sleeping. The dude working at Disney, stealing the engagement ring off the stage. That dude he's just another rat on a motherfucking spinning wheel. The rats first turn to material objects, then things like alcohol when they realize that the happiness they thought they got was short term. After alcohol, it becomes drugs. Eventually, the rat chases the money, which may be a metaphor for happiness, so the rat ends up at a work desk. I think that money can symbolize happiness and how it isn't worth chasing when you're so close to it. In this scene, by the way, the rat is right next to the money despite it, that he doesn't pick it up. I feel like this shows that people who are chasing happiness for so long, when they finally get to it, don't see this the appeal and no longer care about it. When the rat exits the elevator, they begin to chase the money until they get wrapped up in their mousetrap, forcing them to work. Perhaps that symbolizes that the rat will work until he dies. And the reason why it works, other than the fact that he's trapped, is to earn enough money to buy short-term and short-lived happiness. All when the rat was indulging in material objects, when it brought was short, which caused the rat to soon move to other things, which I believe is called short-term happiness. And as opposed to long-term happiness is something that is not striving for.
Yeah, this one's hard because this one I feel like just blew my brain up all night.
It's a never-ending hamster wheel. Things like this are very complex and don't have
concrete answers. It is up for interpretation. Yeah.
Here's how to be happy. Just say you're happy. It's nuanced, but at least if you start poking the bear and asking questions, you're better off than someone who's blinded by consumerism and drugs, alcohol.
And videos like this are good ways to kind of, you know, trigger you to
take a step back, like, oh shit.
Oh yeah.
We really are part of the same little game here.
What makes you happy?
At the end of your life, I guess, you could look back and be like, damn, what would make me the happiest looking back on my life at what I did, or what would you want to accomplish, I guess.
But that's the thing, you can't seek happiness like that, right? Isn't that what they're saying?
Like you can't
like plan for it. What did they just say? I don't know, something like that.
I try to think on my deathbed, what do I want the story of my life to be? Like, what are some things that I would have wanted to have tried or done? All those things are in an attempt to be happy, I guess.
Attempting to be happy?
You have to fight for your happiness every day. And if you don't fight for it, you're going to be handed sadness.
Watch more Strawberry Park, and then you might be a little happier.
We need a podcast, I think.
I think so.
We'll get that.
This is damn near a podcast.
We need to vlog more. Everyone keeps saying that.
We're vlogging. We're going to be happy. But I won't be happy if we don't get any views on the vlogs.
Imagine if we just vlogged all month, but they don't get views. The reactions are getting.
The reactions get great views.
No one watches the vlog, so.
And my happiness is tied to my YouTube views.
And it doesn't have to be, but that's what I'm telling myself it is.
When we were children and didn't have YouTube channels, they didn't care about views. I remember I got 200 views on my first big video, and I was like, oh, we up. I said, I'm viral. I blew up. Now,
look, there's more people in the movie theater.
God. Now, if I get 100,000, I'm like, pull a plug.
What do I need the channel?
Delete it. Delete it. Why am I doing this? No one even cares anymore.
We're trying to figure it out, okay?
We're not completely happy, but we're happy sometimes.
You start arguing and fighting.
It's your fucking fault because we could have.
The reason the views are down.
We're lab rats on a never ending spinning wheel chasing a fucking carrot.
Yeah, and then you take a bite of the carrot and you want something else.
Uh huh.
All right. See y'all later.